Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and we're going to do some cooling system maintenance and repair today. I just wanted to give you a little look under the hood of this vehicle. You see that stripe across the hood there? That is a residue of something that's been thrown by the fan. You look down here and you'll see it's everywhere. Now my intuition says water pump. And I reach down inside the water pump pulley and I come up with a handful of the same stuff. And what is that stuff? Well, that stuff is stop leak that's been dumped in here over a period of time. But I'm going to show you a quick trick about pressure testing this. This is a dinosaur, by the way. That's a 302 Ford engine, 5 liter, to all y'all that don't know 302s. They don't make these anymore. There's still a fair amount of them out there. A lot of people still have them. Tried and true, pretty good motor. Now my favorite in that it's an interference engine. If the timing belt, or timing chain, I'm sorry, when the timing chain does go, it's a good possibility to bend valves. I don't like that, I'm sorry. There's really no excuse for that. A lot of manufacturers still do that, but anyway, you can get a look down in there and see on the back side of the fan itself, that material has thrown all over. But I'm going to show you how to pressure test this, just in case you don't have one of those professional pressure testers. And on a lot of cars, you don't need one. If there is an overflow hose and reservoir, and sometimes even if there's not. All right, remember when you're doing this that the safety cap needs to be on and tight. The safety cap needs to be on and tight, because what we're going to do is put air in behind the safety cap through the return valve, and that will pressurize the system so we can find out where the leak is. So if there were a hole in this hose up here and we pressurized it, then air would come out of here, or antifreeze, and we'd be able to find out where the actual leak is without getting the engine all hot. Because quite frankly, I don't want to get it hot and then work on it. So we remove this hose, or you can remove it from the other end, but I know that the reservoir is full, so I don't want to leak that all over the ground. And we take an air hose like this, and this is a safety air hose. It has side jets on it to keep you from blowing dirt in your eye. And just gently add a little pressure. Aha, I hear it. I don't know if you can hear that or not. Right down there at the base of yon water pump, there is antifreeze, water, and everything going all over. And so we have found our leak, and it is where I anticipated it would be, but then again, I already checked it out earlier today. So now I have a lot of stuff to remove. But that's a quick tip, how to find an antifreeze leak if you have a vehicle with an overflow hose. Now my Buick doesn't have one. We can't do it that way. But if it has one, then you can pressurize it. And I have even got to the point where I put a piece of new hose on it and just blew through it with my lungs to get a little pressure. Okay? Another one in the can. Kevin Bacon. Bye.